today's video, we will teach you how to open the water inlet valve of your washing machine, whether it's a front load or top load model, and how to make a tool for this purpose. This is because in areas where the water is hard, scales often build up inside the valve. Normally, if the valve is clean, you can easily open it with a hose plier and repair it if needed. When the valve is clean, it doesn't usually cause any issues. However, when scales accumulate and it turns completely white and jammed, the piston's movement is obstructed and it requires cleaning. For cleaning, the valve needs to be opened, but without the proper tool, it can be very difficult to open it, no matter how much force you apply. That's why having the proper tool is essential. In this video, we will show you how to make this tool and explain how it works technically. To make this tool, you don't need many expensive resources. If you have a grinder or a hacksaw available, you can easily complete this task. Besides that, you'll need a 22mm pipe, which is typically a standard water pipe, making it easily accessible. The pipe size must be 22mm because most water inlet valves are of this size, so it fits perfectly. Additionally, you'll need two nuts, but later in the video, I'll explain the purpose of these nuts. Out of the two, you can use either one, depending on the requirement. Now let me explain how this valve works. As you can see, water enters from this point, flows through the larger inlet hole, and then exits through the smaller outlet hole. This component here is called the diaphragm, and it has small holes on it as well. I will explain later what the purpose of these holes is. There's also a small hole on the diaphragm itself, which I'll also discuss in detail. Inside, there's a piston and a spring, and I'll explain their roles further in the video. Now, let me explain how this valve works, and it's quite simple to understand. When water enters the valve, it comes with pressure and force. Due to this force, as shown by the two arrows I've drawn, the water pushes against the diaphragm. However, when the diaphragm is closed, the spring and piston from above also apply pressure, keeping the hole sealed. Now, these small micro holes on the diaphragm allow the pressure to equalize gradually. If the pressure on both sides of the diaphragm isn't equal, the diaphragm won't function properly. But over time, the pressure from both sides becomes equal, allowing the diaphragm to stay sealed and ensure the valve functions as intended. Now, when this valve needs to open, a different technique is used, which involves a magnet. When a magnet is applied, it causes the piston to move upward. As the piston moves upward, the hole opens. When this hole opens, the pressure in this area decreases because previously, the pressure was equal on both sides. However, as soon as the hole opens, the water present here flows inward, reducing the pressure at the top. With the reduced pressure, the spring also moves upward. Since the pressure in this area becomes greater, the rubber diaphragm is pushed upward. When the diaphragm moves up, it allows water to flow through and out automatically. Now let me explain why I mentioned the two nuts earlier. If you have the closed nut, like this one, you'll need to keep it on the outside of the tool. However, if you have the open nut, it can fit inside the tool. For this demonstration, I'll use the closed nut. Based on this choice, I'll make the tool slightly shorter to accommodate it. First, take the measurement of the nut and mark its position on the pipe. Once marked, you can cut this section from the pipe. Now as you can see, I have cut it, but there's an issue. I need the wall thickness to be 2mm, but currently it's 3mm. So, to fix this, I will reduce the thickness using an internal grinder. Now you can see that I've reduced the size of the bushing. Additionally, I've made markings on the bushing, dividing it into 6 equal parts. This is because the guide tube is also divided into 6 sections, so this alignment is essential for it to fit and function properly. Now, we will weld this nut onto the bushing. Before welding, we'll ensure it is aligned properly and evenly sized. Once it's positioned correctly, we'll weld it securely in place. Now, the tool is ready. As you can see, the cuts made on the inside allow it to fit perfectly. Just press it inside and it fits snugly. Now, take a ratchet and use it to tighten or loosen the tool as needed. No matter how tight it gets, you won't face any issues. With the help of this tool, you can easily open it without any difficulty. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.